More, keep your back straighter, closer to the thing, go. Nice, like that. Now stop.
Thank you.
That is good for the butterfly. That is good for the freestyle. That's even good for the backstroke. And on breaststroke, we do a underwater pull. It's great for that. Nice. Spread out right there and put your hands like this right now. Ready? Stay right there. Good. Now, you're going to have to bend down like me because we want to make believe you're swimming. And if you can show me this right, I'm going to have you on the raft. Put your hands out like this. Straight out. Down. Apart. EVF. That's EVF, early vertical. Now, push back. Show me your head. Nice. Let's go again. Arms come around, arms come around, arms come around. Out, down, elbows up. And kind of in front of you. There you go. This is the hard part. There you go. Right like that. Don't move. There you go. Just like the elbows up a little bit more. Bend down a little bit. Nice, just like this. Now when I say push back, push all the way back, ready? You're gonna have to bend down just a little bit, bend down like this at your waist, like you're swimming. Okay, ready? When I say push back,
okay.
Go like this. That's where you take your breath, okay? All right.
I don't wanna get in the water, it's cold.
Yes, it is. Welcome to the swimmer's life. We swim early in the morning, we wake up early, and we swim in colder water.
Very funny.
Well, it's true though, right? All right, come on back, bring her back. Catherine, there you go. When you go like this, pick your head up. Nice. Come on, all the way back. When your hands are out of the water, that's when you lift up your head. Give Catherine a hand. Nice job. When you go backwards, point your thumbs down. All right. She gets to get in. Ready? Be careful. There you go.
Okay, right. One, two.
Nice. Augustine, go all the way back and try to keep around. There you go. Look at that. There you go. Thumbs down. Nice. Nice. Give Augie a hand. Now, ladies, when you're on there, watch my thumbs. When you push back, try to keep your thumbs real close to the water. Try it. And straight. Here it goes. All the way back, straight up. There you go. Thumbs close to the water. There you go, that's nice. Thumbs close. All the way back, there you go. All the way back straight, that's a better pull. That's a good pull. Nice.
Do we
get
back?
No, somebody got to switch. Did you already do it?
No.
All right, let's switch. Now you get to be on. Coaches, as much as this sometimes looks like a lot of fun, and it is for them, do it. This type of motion gives them the opportunity to get their arms out of the water without any effort. They get to breathe, and they get to get some of the feeling. Nice, push the water all the way back, nut. There you go. Look at the heads going, nice. Head down first, nice. Bring them around, just like butterfly. That's better. Sierra, very nice. Now coaches, when you buy equipment that you're going to use. I don't know how many times coaches buy a lot of equipment and then don't use it. try the equipment out first, and then when you commit to it because you believe it's gonna make a difference every single day, and the kids don't get a choice. You get a lot of kids complaining about every type of piece of equipment that you have, but if it gets the job done, if it works on something like the tech paddles work on early vertical forearm, I love the snorkels. We use them every day with our middle school. I'm gonna try them the first time with our 8 and unders. One of my buddies invented, these are pretty expensive. They're about $30 to $40 each. And one of my friends invented something that's a little bit cheaper. But I gotta tell you something, these are awesome. Kids can get their face in the water, they can watch their stroke, they don't have to take breaths, they're not worried about breathing. I couple this with the young kids and kids that don't know how to control their breathing with a nose plug. You know, and I give them that opportunity. Good swimmers don't need the nose plug. It's not even good swimmers. If you can control your breath properly, you don't need a nose plug. But for kids that continue to get water up their nose, which is not only uncomfortable, but stops the ability to keep their head in the water, let them use a nose plug, okay? We're gonna use our tech paddles first, and there's a right and a left. So take those off now, and since you put that in your mouth, because these are all clean, I want you to put them someplace so you don't forget where to get them. No, keep them, because those are gonna be yours. We're gonna use those in a minute. Now, put them someplace. Right now, get an R and an L, a right and a left tech paddle, and put one on. If you need some help. Yep, one, two. Now, hey, just a minute. Don't bring your arms out of the water, just sneak them out and do another one, under. Don't do butterfly, just do the butterfly pull. Watch again. Apart, one, two, look at your arms, they should be straight. Then bend them, one, two, push back and try to get your tech paddles out so I see them straight, like this, straight, one, two. Okay, when I say go, I want you to go, put your hands on the wall.
Slower.
Ready, Casey? Say it.
One, two.
Slower. I'm gonna keep my face in the water and watch.
One, two.
Count to three. How's that? Here goes. Ready? You're counting very nice. Now count like three like that, like Sierra. Ready?
One, two, three.
Up to three. Three.
One, two, three. One, two, three.
Bring them up underwater.
One, two, three.
There you go. That's what I want you to do. Ready? Take your mark. Go. This is a very difficult drill. I want to see their paddle. Sierra did it once. These paddles only promote, Sammy, really nice, right there. That's what I wanted to see. And now that she does that, and I find somebody that can do that correctly, I'm gonna get them all out and have her watch. And they're gonna try to duplicate that. Because you wanna praise the correct style. And everybody here wants to do the best they can, so they're gonna wanna duplicate that. That was awesome. And this is a terribly difficult thing to do. I remember driving with one of the, an Olympian, Josh Davis, who said to me, he says, you know, getting a catch is important. And when you can't get it, he works physically and consciously on that specific skill. It's important. Now I want you to watch Sammy. Sammy, what you did is one, two, and you watched. You held them up real nice, one, two. And then I got to see your arms straight with your tech paddles back. We're gonna try that, watch. Go ahead. Take your time. Going. Wow, keep going, that's awesome. Do it again. Hold it, nice. Oh, you ran. Okay, Sammy, come on back. Do it slower, a little bit slower. Now go 5 seconds. Go, and you're gonna have to hold your breath. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two. Okay. Try it again, but 5 seconds. Nice, nice. Do it just like that, real slow. Ready? Go. Nice. Oh, awesome. Awesome. Again, two, three, one. Not. Oh, see how that came out of the water? Oh, nice. Let's slide in. Better, better. Nice. Apart, apart, apart. Hold it. There you go. There you go. When you get your snorkel, come over here. Casey, I want you to try a new invention. Okay? It's my buddy's invention. Let's see if this works. Now, take your goggles off a minute.
Why are you putting two caps on her head?
Well, you got to get your snorkel.
Me?
No, not you. Okay. You're going to try something different. You have a snorkel? I think, ready? I want you to put your snorkels on.
I don't know how to.
If you don't know how to put them on, there you go. Sammy got it on, right?
That's because it was.
Have you done that before? Up. Watch Sammy how she puts hers on. Okay, Casey, put your thumb over here like a regular cap.
Wait, how?
Yep, just put it next to your forehead. Yep. Good. Good. Now watch this. It's pretty cool. Put that in your mouth. That's that.
I can't put them on with these.
You don't have to hold on to them. You can use your fingers without.
I just put on my goggles.
Now, if you need a nose plug, this is what we call a nose plug. You put on. This way, watch this, just like this. And it sits around here so no water goes up your nose. Now, you gotta be careful, because if water gets up here, you gotta kind of spit that out. Now, these are for bigger kids, so I don't know if these are gonna fit you, but they might. You don't have to use these.
Good.
Okay?
I don't need them.
Yeah, you don't need them? All right.
Now, I'm going to put this on.
Okay.
I don't know how.
Well, let's do it this way.
I probably would need it.
Here you go. If you need a nose plug, you grab one. Now put your goggles on. Just use your. No, you don't have to hold on to these. You can just use your hands.
I don't get how you put these on.
Okay, goes like this.
Can I go in the water now?
Just a second. Well, you're gonna have to help me a little bit. You're gonna have to put this next to your. There you go. There you go. And this goes in the front, just like that. Okay. Now, if you need it, yep, you need those. Now, do you remember the drill that we did here?
No.
We just did it.
Yeah.
I want you to do the same thing now. Goes like this. What I like about this idea that. This snorkel can be put in front, side, whatever, but the cost of this whole thing was under $10. And this was $30 or $40. So it just saved me money. I like it. I love these. Just I can't afford them. I can afford some of them. Coaches, you want to accumulate your equipment. The first time you may have 10. Next year when the budget comes here, buy as many as you can. But remember, believe in your equipment and use it. If the equipment is in the storage room, wasting its time and not being used, I don't even see why you bought it. You didn't do your research. If it works, use it and force them to use it. They don't have choices. My kids have to use them or they don't use them. The only reason they wouldn't be using them is I just don't have enough equipment. But remember, accumulate the stuff. All right, slide on in. Oops, sorry. All right, hey, on your own. On your own, don't wait for me. Just try it and practice the same drill without breathing or bringing your head out of the water. There you go.
It hurts.
What? Okay, wait a minute. I got something else for you. Come on out. I'll show you. Here's what I like about this is I can switch. This was one of the really inexpensive snorkels, and here's a different snorkel. She can try as many snorkels as you want. You can buy your own snorkel. I suggest that the kids own their own equipment. I don't want them to have to use our equipment. It's one of our, how's that, is that better? Mm-hmm. All right, try that one. When you can do it right is the first, this is the first time that they're using a snorkel, so you know you have to be patient. But remember, if they do it frequently enough, it becomes second nature. If it's one of those things where you see it's not working, but it's because of the learning curve, be patient. They're 8 and unders, it takes them a little longer. Our middle school guys even took a week to get to take these and master them, so be patient. She seems to get it right away. Nice. There you go. Good. Oh, now that is a nice improvement. Nice, Catherine. Let me show you how to use that.
Coach.
Just put this in your mouth like this. Yeah, and then I'll put it underneath here, like this. Now, you can put your face in the water and you can breathe. You got to keep this part up. Try it.
Can you put on my goggles?
Wait. Oh. Come on out. Come on out. Come on out. Snorkel 101. How did that work? Good, good. I'm gonna show everybody how easy this is to make because I don't even know if it's patentable. I think maybe we'll put a provisional patent on it, but I'll tell you what. I'll take this cap off, you can keep your other one on. It's a cap, and my friend put some holes in it, and you would think, and I would have thought, that this latex would rip apart. It would just rip. I would believe that this would just rip it out and these big holes would become bigger and that would be the end of it. But we've used this for almost a full season and it's still here. This piece of material, it's Velcro, is pennies. The cap was, and I'll tell you what, get the cheapest cap you can. You can buy a cap for $1.99. And this snorkel was one that we bought in a bulk order, and I think they were around $5 or $6. So the whole thing was under 10 bucks, all shipped, and I'm gonna show you how to make it a little bit later on, and I think you'll really enjoy that. Anytime a coach spends or saves money is a good thing, right? All right, let's go on to our next one. We're gonna go on to turns. Put your hands on the wall. We're gonna go on to butterfly turns and breaststroke, as they're saying. No. Stand, put your hand on the wall. We're gonna do breaststroke turns. All right. Yes.
That made me hold my breaststroke.
Did it?
Yeah, I can hold my breaststroke.
You know, I gotta tell you something. I gotta tell you something, coaches. Coaches don't understand this because we really haven't thought about a snorkel this way. But the resistance that it causes to take air from this spot, go here into your trachea, increases the need to breathe in deeper and exhale. I've known coaches that actually tape this area so it's even more difficult to breathe in, but it's great for your lungs. So, you know, for these kids, gonna become one of my training regimes, you know, the snorkels. Now, we can't afford them. This is a different pool, and our budget's a little bit bigger, but we'll accumulate these and make them use them. All the way back. On a count of three, when I say go, you're gonna put both feet on the wall as fast as you can. Go! Sammy, you won again. Do it again, ready? Wait a minute, I'm on it. You can do this, Augustine, this is fun. Ready? Both feet backwards. Put your arms out straighter. Straighter legs. Go! Arian, you won it that time. Let's do it again, ready? Both feet back. Put your arms straight. Go! On the count of three. Ready? Whoa, stretch out your arms.
Oh, it's better, I got it.
Did you get it? Ready? Oh, no, start with your legs backwards. Go! Back that way. You want your head pointing that way and your ear in the water. Now try to do that real quick. Here goes. On the count of three.
Wait.
Straight. Augustine, try this a minute. Come over here and watch. Ready? Go! That was quick. There you go. Go! Oh, excellent, excellent. Last thing you have to do is when you put your ear in, okay, I want you to pull yourself underwater.
I don't get it.
You don't get it?
Do we go like this? Ah!
This is the time I have to put on a swimsuit.
Wait, do we split?
Huh? Nope, this is a breaststroke turn. All right, everybody, come on out. All right. When the skill becomes so complicated that they don't understand it, it's the time for the coach to get in the water, okay? So I know coaches don't like to get in the water, but you have to do it. All right, these turns, breaststroke and butterfly turns, are the same. They're basically the same. You got to get your feet on the wall before your competitor, and you got to get off the wall in a streamlined position faster than your competitor. So I'm going to show you this, and I want to see if you can duplicate it, okay? I want you to try to copy it.
Right? Okay. Okay.
Start like this. I'm going to do a slow motion. One on the wall. Now watch. I'm looking up. Now my head's facing that way. Looking straight up in a straight line. I don't want to go sideways. I want to go straight back. Now watch what I do with my hand. I'm going to take my elbow and put my hand up and watch. Now I went all the way to the backstroke flags and I didn't even have to take a pull yet. I hope you can get that far on just a push-up. Okay? Now, here I'm coming in.
You do it again.
Here's the race. I'm doing breaststroke or butterfly. I touch two hands. Watch. Get my feet on the wall first. Look where my hand is. See how it's up in the air like this? That gets to pull me underwater. Are you paying attention? Can you do this in slow motion? Okay, you talk me through it. You tell me what to do, and if you tell me correctly, I'll let you get in the water. One person talks. That's going to be you, Casey. Tell me what to do. No, because I touched one hand. That's illegal. You're supposed to tell me touch two hands. Tell me. The wall. Say a little bit louder.
And leave your arms out.
I gotta get underwater. Ready? That was pretty good. Say it again now, real loud so the camera can hear you. Ready?
Put your hands on the wall. Put your feet on the wall. Put your head back.
No, okay, right.
And put one arm out.
Now we're gonna have to say put our elbow back and arm out.
Put our elbow back and arm out.
Okay.
And push off the wall.
Okay, now watch what this hand does. Watch what this hand does. It's like answering a telephone. Putting a telephone by your ear. Watch this. Feet out, hands on the wall. Feet on the wall. Heads backwards. Now don't kiss the wall. Bring your head back quickly, like this. Now watch. You gotta push off on your belly, okay?
Push off.
Tell me what I'm doing wrong here. Here goes, ready? What was wrong? Yeah.
You weren't going underwater.
I didn't go underwater. That's very hard. People push off before they get underwater. One more time, say it together this time. No, everybody's not saying it together.
Go.
Oh, you got
go
say,
underwater like you're answering a telephone. Come back up.
Get straight like you're actually swimming. Okay, hands on the wall. Catherine, put your feet back.
Feet back.
Darian, put your feet back.
Yeah.
Feet on the wall.
Yeah.
Feet on the wall. Go. Head back. Head back. One hand off. Underwater and push. Not too bad. Sierra, you didn't go underwater.
What?
You didn't go underwater. Let's do it again. Ready? Hands on the wall. That was nice. Don't do any pulling. I want you to push off, streamline underneath this flag underwater.